such hubris. To think that they could control what they did not understand. Oh, it's always hubris with the Terrans. Get too close to a black hole, and it will crush you.
We once thought the same of the Tal Darim, Alarak. We believed you mindless and obedient slaves.
And we thought you were weak, impure, and unworthy. And yet now we stand together.
Perhaps we acted too rashly with Mobius Core. There may have been a different way.
Oh, Templar, is there ever a moment when your people do not doubt themselves? No, Artanis. Extermination was the only course. The hybrid leave nothing to save.
Our scouts are reporting the Dominion is attempting to fight back the Golden Armada. Despite their efforts, multiple systems have fallen.
Rohanna!
I can see it, Artanis. The truth Amon wishes to hide. While his brethren, the Zelnaga, slumbered through the millennia, Amon and his followers descended upon Ire.
And he uplifted our people. They ruled over us as teachers, as gods.
He changed us, manipulated our essence. But we grew beyond his control. He and his followers fled to Zaris to create the Zerg. The hybrid are the culmination of his efforts. False Zelnaga, created in his image. We must...
Rohanna, this is too dangerous. You cannot go on like this.
I must, Hierarch. It is my duty to know the truth, to bear it. I know now. This is my purpose.
Capital ships have docked within the Spear of Adun. They await your preference.
Carrier has arrived.
Valor is eternal.
Deeds of a Templar suit you, Karax.
For the entirety of my life, I have given myself to the art of creation. My war has been one of design, a battle against obstacles that hinder optimization. I am a facesmith, and will always be my first calling. But as times change, those who were not born true Templar can become so through their deeds.
Then ready yourself, Templar. You will be needed.
The glory of victory is yours, Hierarch.
I would call it vengeance, Phoenix. Vengeance demanded by the blood of warriors.
And yet you have delivered a powerful blow to Amon. You truly have come far from the Executor I saw encoded in my memories.
It is a role I never intended to fill, old friend. It is one I have grown into.
You bear the burden of leadership more capably than you let yourself believe. It is an honor to fight at your side.
Greetings, Hierarch.
Revanskar has fallen, and through its death... I have made a decision many of you will not agree with. During my time with Phoenix, I have seen that the Purifier program, under the right guidance, may be reborn.
History has shown the Purifiers cannot be controlled, Artanis.
They do not have to be. These personalities, like I, will have free will.
We do not have enough Purifier matrices to create more like Phoenix.
You cannot possibly be considering what I think you are.
The original Purifiers are housed in orbit above the forest world of Endion, sealed within their warship, Cybros. I have seen, through Phoenix, that these warriors may be valuable to us. Perhaps the Conclave misunderstood them, treating them as simple robots and not proud Templar. It tried to control them.
And they rebelled, attacking their creators.
Would you not rebel against a slave master?
I have heard your counsel, and I have chosen to go to Endion. We leave at once!
The Purifier stasis grid is still intact. We'll have to destabilize it from the generator below. I'm detecting a massive Zerg infestation on the surface. They can't be Kerrigan's.
Amon's brood. This will not be easy.
The Golden Armada has devastated the sector, Artanis. I know we can't...
What you plan to do is awaken monsters, Artanis. They slaughtered every Templar on the base of Lentinum.
They rose against their masters. Our people never treated them as Templar.
Because they are robots, created to do the bidding of the Conclave.
Is this what you think of Phoenix? A robot whose only purpose is to do your bidding?
He certainly defies expectations. He is... more.
Perhaps the original Purifier robots will be too. If nothing else, think of their benefit to the war effort.
That is, if they choose to join us.
I believe in Phoenix. I am willing to take the risk.
I know this will work, Hierarch. I know I can guide the Purifiers through the darkness that lies ahead. Help them accept what they are. I can convince them that they will not be treated as servants again.
Then it appears as if you have found purpose, brother.
Since awakening, I have been confused, directionless, uncertain of what I am, how I came to be. Now, things are clear once more. Fate has laid out a purpose only I can accomplish. It is exhilarating.
Yes. You embark upon a task that even Phoenix could not achieve.
Yet he would attempt it if he could. I have learned much from Phoenix's memories, and through them, I have come to know myself. I am Phoenix, but not. I am my own entity, and I take pride in this.
The Zerg pose quite a problem. Disrupting the stasis grid was never going to be easy, and it certainly will be less so with Amon's brood attacking us.
We will hold them off long enough for your work, Karax.
The scientists sealed away Cybros with a device called the Megalith. It is the key to disabling the station's stasis lock. Once the grid is down, we have to act swiftly and bring Cybros online or flee orbit. The might of the brood below is too great.
Leave the defense to me.
The shield emitters on Endion must be disabled if we are to reactivate Cybros. The time to begin is now, Hierarch. Syros, the Vault of the Purifiers. It is fortunate that Amon's brood has been unable to penetrate its stasis grid.
I now have access to Endion's records. The stasis grid is sealed by complicated locking mechanisms. They can only be destabilized by a certain device. The Megalith. I'll begin recovering it now, so it may work on the locks.
It will need protection. These forests already crawl with Zerg abominations.
Then we shall clear them out.
If I may, Hierarch, this facility once developed powerful weapons for the Empire.
I have heard tale of the mighty Colossi, scaling cliffs, besieging enemies from afar. Let us see how they fare against the Zerg.
From that cave. If we fire on the rock formation, it will seal the opening.
Secure. Warp coordinates for our Nexus port are locked. Karax, activate the Megalith.
Authorization in progress. The Megalith should be ready shortly, Hierarch. We will monitor its status and alert you when it is online. The Megalith systems will take a few moments to activate. It will be ready to move out soon. In the meantime, I've upgraded our robotics facilities to construct Colossi. You can warp them in whenever you wish, Hierarch. Megalith should be finishing up shortly. We should ensure that we have enough forces to defend it.
megalith is online. We must ensure it reaches the stasis locks safely.
We await our charge. We stand in escort.
Has reached the first stasis lock. It will be safe below the surface as it does its work.
Nexus point.
Megalith is almost done with this lock. I would advise you to make preparations for its next move.
Paradactyl.
The canyon grows narrow ahead. Crawlers, they're rooting on the ridge. Brace for incoming fire.
Sensors show the first stasis lock has been disabled. The megalith is relocating to the next one.
Safely at the second stasis lock. It shall be brought down shortly.
Interesting. I believe this facility used power cores of incredible size to provide energy for experiments. They should be hidden somewhere within these hills. If our warriors can destroy them, we can claim the solarite components within.
The Shadow Gods. We are at full power.
The first power core has been secured. Warping it aboard now.
Done.
The megalith's work is nearly complete. It will move again soon. Disabled, and the grid is now at 60%. The megalith is en route to the third lock now.
Disabling the third lock.
Both power cores have been obtained. I'll begin working on them immediately. Detecting a large number of Zerg bioforms in the cave network ahead.
We can use the terrain to our advantage. Topple the rock formations near the entrance and seal the Zerg within the caves.
Additional pylons.
Zak Naku Afal. Systems at
a significant number of Zerg have been detected in the caves ahead. Exercise caution. This lock is almost destabilized. The megalith will relocate shortly.
Face the enemy.
Is on the move. My readout shows Cybros beginning to awaken from stasis. Only two remain, Hierarch.
It's Yaradakaral. Annihilation commencing. Processed.
There is an entire Zerg hive cluster between the megalith and the last stasis lock. Our only option is to fight through it.
Link authorized. The megalith is now disabling the fourth lock.
It shall be. Commencing. It shall be done.
Destabilization is nearly finished. The megalith will disembark soon.
Paradakural.
Systems out. down and the megalith is traveling. Stasis grid at 20%. Wait, I'm detecting activity in the Zerg hive nearby. They're reinforcing the last lock.
Zaknaku Afal. This vessel shall avenge. Channel the light of Ayur. Systems at full. Calibrate void lenses. Kas Arashar. Processed. Undercool her rock.
The final lock is destabilizing, and the grid is down. We've done it! Cybros is free from stasis.
Recall our forces from Endion's surface. We take this battle to Cybros.
A new faction has joined our forces in the War Council.